Good morning everyone, my name is Ram Babu. Today we are going to solve some problems in chapter number 1, 10th class real numbers, exercise number 1.1. What is given in the problem? So before you going to watch this video, you watch my previous videos, Euclid division lemma and Euclid division algorithm. Generally you can understand very easily. Watching this video you can write the notes also. What is given in the problem? Use Euclid division lemma to show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5, where q is some integers. We know about Euclid division lemma. What is Euclid division lemma? Given any positive integers a and b, their digits, the unique pair of integers q and r satisfying a equal to bq plus r, 0 less than equal to r less than b. Here a equal to dividend, b equal to divisor, q is equal to quotient, r equal to remainder. Remainder is always less than the divisor. This is a equal to bq plus r. Let a be any positive integer and b equal to 6. Then by Euclid division lemma, b equal to 6, we write the equation number 1, a equal to 6q plus r, 0 less than or equal to r less than 6. So here r is the remainder. If b equal to 6, the possible remainders r equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Substitute the remainders in equation number 1. This is equation number 1. If b equal to 6, r equal to 0, a equal to 6q plus r. R equal to 0 is nothing but 6q. R equal to 1, the equation is a equal to 6q plus 1. R equal to, if r equal to 2, a equal to 6q plus 2. R equal to 3, a equal to 6q plus 3. In the same way, substitute the r values like that. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If r equal to 4, a equal to 6q plus 4. These are the remainders, possible remainders, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the possible dividends. A is the dividend. Possible dividends, 6q, 6q plus 1, 6q plus 2, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 4, 6q plus 5. These are the possible dividends, 6q, 6q plus 1, 6q plus 2, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 4, 6q plus 5. These are the possible dividends. So see here, 6q is a even number. This is even number because the 6q is the exactly divisible by 2. 2 into 3q, exactly. So next consecutive number 6q plus 1, odd number. Next 6q plus 2 are also even number because it is exactly divisible by 2. Even number. Next consecutive number, odd number. Next even number. So see here, 6q is the even number, 6q plus 1 odd, 6q plus 2 even, 6q plus 3 odd, next consecutive number 6q plus 4 even, 6q plus 5 odd number. These are the possible dividends, 6q plus 1 and 6q plus 3, 6q plus 5 are odd numbers. Next third problem, look at the problem on the blackboard once. What is given in the problem? Use Euclid division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is of the form of 3p, 3p plus 1, 3p plus 2. Let a be any positive integer. We apply the Euclid division lemma A and B equal to 3. You know Euclid division lemma. What is Euclid division lemma? Given positive integers A and B, their edges, unique pair of integers Q and R satisfying A equal to BQ plus R, where R 0 less than equal to R less than B. Less than B. This is the Euclid division lemma. This is the condition. A is dividend, B equal divisor, Q is equal to quotient, and R is equal to remainder. Remainder is equal and greater than 0 but less than divisor. Let A be any positive integer and B equal to 3. Then by Euclid division lemma we get A equal to 3Q. 3 is nothing but B. B. B equal to 3. 3Q plus R 0 less than equal to R less than 3. Less than. If B equal to 3, so the possible remainders are R equal to 0, 1, 2. These are the possible remainders. Then by Euclid division lemma we get A equal to 3Q plus R, 0 less than or equal to R less than 3. So B equal to 3. If B equal to 3, then the possible remainders are 0, 1, 2. The possible remainders are 0, 1, 2. Then dividends 3Q, 3Q plus 1. A equal to 3Q, A equal to 3Q plus 1. A equal to 3Q plus 2. These are the possible dividends. Case 1. A equal to 3Q. Squaring on both sides. A square equal to 3Q whole square. It is nothing but 9Q square. 9Q square. Case 1. A equal to 3Q. Squaring on both sides. A square equal to 3Q whole square. It is nothing but 9Q square. 3 into 3Q square. 3Q square in the place of we substitute the P, therefore 3P, this is the 3P, A square equal to 3P. Case 2, A equal to 3Q plus 1, squaring on both sides, A square equal to 3Q plus 1 whole square, it is nothing but A plus B whole square in the form of A plus B whole square, 9Q square plus 6Q plus 1, these two terms, 9Q square plus 6Q, take 3 on the common. A equal to A square equal to 3 into 3Q square plus 2Q out of plus 1. 3Q square plus 2Q is in the place of 3Q square plus 2Q. Substitute the value of P. Therefore, A square equal to 3P plus 1. Case 3. A equal to 3Q plus 2. Squaring on both sides. A square equal to 3Q plus 2 whole square. Expands the A plus B whole square. 9q square plus 12q plus 4. 4 is split on the two terms 3 plus 1. These three terms take 3 is the common. 3 into 9, 3q square plus 4q plus 1 plus 1. In the place of 3q square plus 4q plus 1 will be 3p plus 1. 3p plus 1. The square of any positive integer is of the form 3p. 3p plus 1. 10th class first chapter. Real numbers. Exercise 1.1. Fourth problem. What is asking? Use Euclid's division lemma to show that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m, 9m plus 1, 9m plus 8. In the previous problem, the square of any positive integer is of the form of 3p, 3p plus 1. This is fourth one. This is asking to find the cube of any positive integer 9m, 9m plus 1, 9m plus 8. Before you going to solve the problem, you see how can you solve it. Let A be any positive integer, then it is of the form of 3q, 3q plus 1, 3q plus 8, some integers q. Before going to solve the problem, you see how can you solve it. Let A be any positive integer, then it is the form of 3q, 3q plus 1, 3q plus 2, some integers q. A equal to 3q, A equal to 3q plus 1, A equal to 3q plus 2. This is the proven statement, need not be proved. Case 1, a equal to 3 cube. Cubing on both sides, cube of any positive integers. Case 1, a equal to 3 cube, cubing on both sides, a cube equal to 27, q cube. Therefore, a cube equal to 3 into 9 q cube. 9 cube, cube. 9 q cube in the place of 9 q cube. In the place of 9 q cube, you substitute the m. Therefore, a equal to 3m. Case 2, a equal to 3 cube plus 1. Cubing on both sides, a cube equal to 3 cube plus 1 over cube. A cube equal to 27 q cube plus 27 q square plus 9 cube plus 1. A cube equal to 3 into 9 q cube plus 9 q plus 3 q plus 1. How does it plus 1? Therefore, in the place of 9 q cube plus 9 q square plus 3 q, in substitute m, 9 q cube plus 9 q square plus 3 q equal to m. In the place of 9 q cube plus 9 q square plus 9 3 q equal to substitute m. Therefore, in the form a cube equal to 9 3 m plus 1. 3 in the form 3 m plus 1. Now take a equal to 3 cube plus 2. Cubing on both sides, a cube equal to 3 cube plus 2 whole cube. A cube equal to 27 q cube plus 18 q square. A cube, a plus b whole cube equal to a cube plus 3 a square b plus 3 a b square plus b cube. A cube equal to 27 a cube cube plus 18 q square plus 36 q plus 8. These are three terms. We take three common. The a cube equal to 3 into 9 cube plus 6 q square plus 12 q plus 8 out of 8. Now in the place of 9 q cube plus 6 q square plus 12 q, substitute m. Then in the form a cube equal to 3 m plus 8. A is any positive integer. B equal to 9. Actually, you take b equal to 9, but the problem is very lengthy. B equal to 3. Possible remainders are 0, 1, 2. These are the possible remainders. So a equal to 3 cube plus 3 cube plus 1, 3 cube plus 2. So the cube of, we conclude that the cube of any positive integers 3m plus 1 and 3m plus 8. Next problem, fifth problem. Show that one and only one out of n plus 2 or n plus 4 is divisible by 3, where n is any positive integer. You can write the notes watching the video. Now solve the problem. Let n be any positive integer. Out of 3 numbers n plus 2, n plus 4, we should prove only one number is divisible by 3. Let we take n equal to 1, substitute the value n equal to 1. This is 1, this is 3, this is 5. Out of 3 these numbers, 3 numbers, how many numbers divisible by 3? Only one number. Only one number, 3. Only number 3. 1 and 5 are not divisible by 3. Okay. We take n equal to 2. We get n equal to 2. This is 2. This is 4. This is 6. Now, out of these 3 numbers, how many numbers divisible by 3? 2, only 6 is divisible by 3. 2 and 4 are not divisible by 3. Now we take n equal to 3. This is n equal to 3, n equal to 3. N plus 2 is nothing but 3 plus 2 is 5. N plus 4 is nothing but 7. Out of these 3 numbers, how many numbers divisible by 3? Only one number. That is 3. 5 and 7 are not divisible by 3. Like this, if you take n equal to 10, n equal to 20, n equal to 50, n equal to 100, only one number is divisible by 3. We take, suppose you take n is equal to 10, n equal to 10, this is 10, next n plus 2 is 12, n plus 4 is 14. Out of these three numbers, only one number, 12, only one number is divisible by 3. 10 and 14 are not divisible by 3. So, we conclude n plus 2, n plus 4, these three numbers, only one and only number is divisible by 3. Let us generalize the problem and solve it. Now, I want to explain one thing. 3 is divisible by 3. Which number divisible by 3 next? 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 is 3 is divisible by 3. Next 6 is divisible by 3. Next number, which number is divisible by 3 after 6? 6 plus 3 equal to 9 is divisible by 3. Suppose 3 is divisible by 3. 6, 9 like this, 12 are divisible by 3. 3 is divisible by 3. 4, 5, 7, 8 are not divisible by 3. 3 is divisible by 3. These numbers are 4, 5, 7, 8, so on like that. These numbers are not divisible by 3. Now do this problem, this concept. 3 is divisible by 3. The next number divisible by 3, which number is divisible by 3? 3 plus 3, 6. After that, the next number which is divisible by 3? 6 plus 3, 9. Yes, 1. Out of these 3 numbers, n plus 2, n plus 4, n plus 4, we prove that only one number is divisible by 3. Suppose we assume n is divisible by 3, the next number of n is divisible by 3 is n plus 3. N plus 3 is divisible by 3. The next number n plus 3 plus 3, it is nothing but n plus 6. Suppose you assume n is divisible by 3, n plus 3 and n plus 6 are divisible by 3. What about the n plus 2 and n plus 4? The n plus 2 and n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. Out of these 3 numbers, n plus 2, n plus 4, in this case, n is one and only one number is divisible by 3. N plus 2, n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. Write the notes carefully. Case 2. Now, these 3 numbers, n plus 2, n plus 4. Out of these 3 numbers, case 2, we take 3 numbers, n plus 2, n plus 4. Out of these 3 numbers, we assume that n plus 2 is divisible by 3. The next number, the n plus 2 is divisible, suppose n plus 2 is divisible by 3. The next, which number divisible by 3 after n plus 2? Next n plus 2, n plus 2 plus 3, that is n plus 5. You need not about to, after numbers, the last number is n plus 4. The previous number of the n plus 2 is n plus 2, the previous number of the n plus 2 is divisible by 2 is which number? N plus 2 minus 3, n minus 1. So, if n plus 2 is divisible by 3, n minus 1 and n plus 5 are divisible by 3. So, n and n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. In this case, n plus 2 is divisible by 3, n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. Now, we conclude that case 2. Out of these 3 numbers, n plus 2 is divisible by 3. Now, one and only number, that number is n plus 2, is divisible by 3. N and n plus 4 are not divisible by Case 3, n, these three numbers, n, n plus 2, n plus 4, out of these three numbers, n plus 4 is divisible by 3. The next number, we need not worry about the next number, because n plus 4, the number n plus 4 is here. The next number n plus 4 plus 4 n plus 5 is not in the set of these the given numbers. We need to worry about the previous numbers. The previous number of the n plus 4 divisible by 3 is n plus 4 minus 3. That is, it is nothing but n plus 1. So, now the previous number is divisible by 3. Is n plus 1, n plus 1 minus 3, n minus 2. So, the if n plus 4 is divisible by 3, n plus 1 and n minus 2 are divisible by 3. N minus 2, n plus 1 and n plus 4, this set is divisible by 3. N and n plus 2 are not divisible by 3. So, out of these three numbers, n plus 4 is one and only number is divisible by 3. N and n plus 2 are not divisible by 3. The case number 1, if n is divisible by 3, n plus 2, n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. Case number 2, suppose n plus 2 is divisible by 2, divisible by 3, n and n plus 4 are not divisible by 3. Case number 3, n plus 4 is divisible by 3, n and n plus 2 are not divisible by 3. We observe the three cases. We prove that only one and only number out of these three numbers, n, n plus 2, n plus 4, these three numbers, only one and only number is divisible by 3.